Good morning, students. Today I am going to discuss one other topic for class 12. My topic is sexual reproduction in flowering plant. Today I am going to discuss the sexual reproduction in flowering plant. As you know that reproduction is one of the important phenomena of living organism. Reproduction helps to maintain the continuity of life, and it takes part, sexual reproduction takes part in evolution. So in flowering plant it is also very important phenomena. Now the reproductive part of flower is the reproductive part of flowering plant is flower. So flower is a modified shoot. Actually flower is a modified shoot, and when the plant get mature it produces flower for sexual reproduction. There are four parts present in flower. The flower, it means flower have four parts. The first part is calyx, second part is corolla, third part is androecium, and fourth part is gynoecium. Calyx is the outermost pore of the flower. It is green in color. This is the diagram of a typical flower. It is a longitudinal section of a typical flower. So actually flower is all parts of the flower placed on a solid part. That solid part is called thallamus. This solid part is called thallamus, and it is attached with the plant with a stalk-like structure. That stalk-like structure is called pedicel. So this is the pedicel. Now on the thallamus, four parts. These four parts are arranged. So this is the outermost pore of the flower. This outermost pore is called calyx. The outermost pore is called calyx. Its unit is called sepal. Its unit is called sepal. It is leaf-like in a structure and it is green in color. Now the second most pore of the plant is called corolla. This is the second most pore, and its unit is called petal. Its unit is called petal. It is brightly colored, and it is also flattened in a structure, leaf-like flattened in a structure. They are in different color, different shapes they have. Now, third part is called androecium. These are the androecium, and its unit is called stamen. Its unit is called stamen. This is the essential part of the flower. It is also called male reproductive parts. Calyx and corolla, they are called accessories part of the flower. But these two, androecium and gynoecium, they are called essential part of the flower. And its unit is called stamen. Now the fourth pore is called gynoecium. Its unit is called carpel. This is the fourth pore. It means it is situated in a middle, in the center of the flower, and this unit is called carpel. Now, structure, function of different parts of the flower. The first part, that is called the calyx, it is green in color, and its main function is protection. It protects the flower when it is in bud stage. And second function, it takes part in photosynthesis. Because it is green in color and it produces food for the plant. Now the function of corolla. This unit is petals. It is also a leaf-like structure. It is brightly in color. Some petals have pleasant smells, so that it helps in pollination. Pollination is essential phenomena for sexual reproduction and second function is protection of essential whole. Corolla also protect essential holes. I have already told you that androecium and gynoecium, these are the essential whole of the flower, because they are, androecium is male reproductive organ and gynoecium is female reproductive organ. So these are the essential whole. So corolla protect the essential whole in bud stage. Now the function of stamen. I have already told you that stamen is the male reproductive organ and it produces pollen grains. So pollen grain is the male gamete. So stamen produces pollen grain, because stamens have anther. Inside the anther, pollen grains are produced. Now the function of carpel. Carpel, it is a female reproductive organ of the flower. And it produces ovule. Ovule is a female gamete. So these are the function of different parts of the flower. Now, on the basis of sex organ, flowers are divided into two categories. Means there are two types of flower on the basis of presence and absence of sex organ. If only one kind of sex organs are present in a flower, they are called unisexual flower. It means either male sex organ or female sex organ are present in a flower, that types of sex organ are present are called unisexual flower. If both kinds of sex organs are present, they are called bisexual flower. Both kinds of stamen and carpel, if both kinds of sex organs are present in a flower, this type of sex organ is called bisexual flower. For example, examples of the unisexual flower: watermelon, pumpkin. These are the all the cucurbit plants produces unisexual flower. So unisexual flower and bisexual flower, mustard, hibiscus, they produces bisexual flower. It means both kinds of sex organs are present on the same flower. Now types of plant on the basis of flower. There are two types of plant. One is monoecious plant and second is dioecious plant. Monoecious plant, if plant produces both kinds of flower, plant produces both male flower and female flower. Both kinds of flower, either male flower and female flower, they are called monoecious plant. For example, cucurbits, maize, they produces both kinds of flower. Unisexual flower, either male flower or female flower, both kinds of flower they produces in. So they are called monoecious. Dioecious, they produces only one kind of flower, either male flower or female flower. They are called dioecious plant. It means a plant जो है सिर्फ एक ही तरह का plant flower produce, या तो male flower produce करेगा या तो female flower. If they produces male flower, the plant is called male plant. If they produces female flower, the plant is called female plant. Example, palm, papaya. तो ये एक ही तरह का flower produce करता है, या तो male करेगा या तो female करेगा. लेकिन monoecious plant यानी दोनों तरह का flower produce करता है एक ही प्लांट में, लेकिन अलग अलग जगहों पर. तो इसको कहते हैं मोनोशियस प्लांट. कुकरबिट्स, इतने तरह का कुकरबिट्स इसके एग्जाम्पल्स हैं, मेज इसके एग्जाम्पल्स हैं, यहाँ पर पाम ट्री, पपाया, ये इसका एग्जाम्पल्स आ गया. नाउ कभी कभी ऐसा होता है कि फ्लावर सिर्फ सिंगल फ्लावर, कुछ प्लांट सिंगल फ्लावर, एक एक्सिस पर एक ही फ्लावर प्रोड्यूस करता है, सिंगल फ्लावर, खूब सिंगल फ्लावर हो गया. लेकिन कहीं कहीं ऐसा हम लोग देखते हैं, समटाइम्स दे प्रोड्यूसेस अ क्लस्टर ऑफ फ्लावर्स, दे प्रोड्यूसेस क्लस्टर ऑफ फ्लावर्स। तो जब क्लस्टर ऑफ फ्लावर प्रोड्यूस करता है तो उस पूरे एक्सिस को, फ्लावर का जो एक्सिस है, एक्सिस इज कॉल्ड इनफ्लोरेसेंस। हियर इज द इनफ्लोरेसेंस। सो डेफिनेशन इज एन एक्सिस बियरिंग, एन एक्सिस बियरिंग अ क्लस्टर ऑफ फ्लावर इज नोन एज इनफ्लोरेसेंस। दे प्रोड्यूस क्लस्टर ऑफ फ्लावर, तो ये प्रोड्यूस होता है। अब आ जाइए ओवरऑल द फंक्शन ऑफ फ्लावर। फ्लावर जैसे मैंने पहले ही बता दिया है कि फ्लावर जो है वो एक रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन है, प्लांट का रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन है। तो इसका क्या फंक्शन, ओवरऑल यहाँ पर जितने भी फंक्शन मैंने बताया वो सब इंक्लूड करके फंक्शंस ऑफ फ्लावर। द फर्स्ट है इट बेयर्स मेल एंड फीमेल सेक्स ऑर्गन फॉर द सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। मेल एंड फीमेल सेक्स ऑर्गन्स आर प्रोड्यूस आर प्रेजेंट इन अ फ्लावर। सेकेंड द फंक्शन इज इट टेक्स पार्ट इन सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। थर्ड फंक्शन इज इट टेक्स पार्ट इन फॉर्मेशन ऑफ फ्रूट एंड सीड्स। तो ये था फ्लावर के बारे में इसका डिस्क्रिप्शन। अब हम अगले वीडियो में इसके आगे की टॉपिक को डिस्कस करेंगे। थैंक यू।